The city of Mulanay in the Philippine province of Quezon now under a state of calamity after the onslaught of Christine. Mulanay's mayor, Aris Aguirre, says several homes were destroyed due to extreme flooding. Aguirre recounts floodwater swept away light structures and even reached a point where it was higher than average person. The city now appealing for help from the provincial and national government.
Catastrophic po talaga yung nangyari po sa amin. Unexpected. Kasi signal number one lang ang unang warning po sa amin ng pag-asa. Pero hindi po namin na-expect na yung ulan na dala-dala po nitong bagyo ay napakatindi.
Over 2 million Filipinos across the country are feeling the brunt of severe tropical storm Christine. The Social Welfare Department says most of the affected hail from the storm-hit region of Bicol. The DSWD notes some 2 million family food packs are ready to be distributed. Secretary Rex Gatchalian reassures the public his agency has enough stockpile of goods to assist everyone affected by the storm.
So we're ready. Sa katunayan, kausap ko kahapon si Mayor Legacion. The day before, kausap ko si Congressman Elrey Villafuerte. Kausap ko rin kahapon ng ating acting governor ng Albay, si Vice Governor Glenda. At ang assurance namin sa kanila, bagamat sila ang first line of defense, ang local government units, handang-handa ang pamalang nasyonal na i-augment o dagdagan ang kanilang mga supply.
The state operator of dams in the Philippines will implement new protocols for the release of water from its facilities. The NAPCO said Thursday it was abandoning the old practice of waiting for dams to reach full capacity before beginning to release water. A 24-hour notice for nearby local governments will also be issued before dams discharge water. NAPCO says the move will help prevent massive flooding in communities during typhoons.
With the recent amendments of our protocol, so we are working on it right now. So we parang nagagarantee na po namin yung assurance sa mga downstream communities na yung mga past experiences po natin with the dams. Marami po tayong mga lesson learned about it eh.
A cargo vessel has ran aground due to Christine in Pangasinan. Meanwhile, the famed surfing capital of the North, La Union, also not spared from the wrath of the storm. Lady Vicentia has those stories.
A dredger ran aground along the coastal waters of Binmali, Pangasinan. Initial details from the Binmali MBRMO say the vessel came from the town of Sual when it was battered by storm surge along Lingayen Gulf Wednesday night. Philippine Coast Guard Pangasinan said they have identified the owner of the vessel, but retrieval efforts cannot be done as of the moment with these severe sea conditions. While no oil sheen from the vessel is visible as of the moment, it remains under monitoring as the incident is subject to marine casualty investigation. Meanwhile, here in La Union, with the current weather disturbance, San Juan La Union surfing area is still closed to swimmers and surfers. Business owners in the surfing capital of the North are directly hit with the lack of tourists despite being open for business. But as severe tropical storm Christine brings huge waves along the coast, cottages were also damaged, causing double losses for owners. Rental for open cottages in the surf town ranges from 800 pesos to 1,500 pesos. Some cottage owners have also been going on for 3 days without income. For bigger establishments like hotels and restaurants, guests are still welcome to stay but are prohibited to go near the beach area.
Cargo vessel also ran aground in Minglanilla town in Cebu province. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Annie Perez. Annie?
Hi, Ron. The cargo vessel ran aground, specifically in Sitio Nova, Barangay Kalahoan in Minglanilla, that's in south of Cebu, due to the strong winds brought about by severe tropical storm Christine. Based on investigation by the Philippine Coast Guard Central Visayas, the vessel was anchoring near the area after it could not proceed to its destination following the inclement weather. It came from Tawi-Tawi and it was on its way to Naga City, and it's about 2 or 3 towns away from Minglanilla where it supposedly took shelter. And when the strong winds occurred yesterday, the vessel was dragged toward the shore and it also experienced rough seas and rising tide. Both of the anchors of the vessel broke, leaving the vessel without holding power, and it became vulnerable to the weather condition. As of today, the Coast Guard reported that it is only 100 meters from the shoreline and it continues to move closer due to the tide. They are now conducting underwater hull inspections to assess if there are any possible hull breaches, monitoring oil spill, along with implementing contingencies in place. They will extract the vessel by a tugboat once the inspection is done. Meanwhile, the suspension of trips here in Central Visayas are already partially lifted, according to the Philippine Coast Guard. Those with vessels 250 gross tonnage and above were already allowed to depart from the different ports of the region. But the Philippine Coast Guard said that they still logged stranded passengers. There are about 498 along the different ports in the region. 33 vessels from the regional 60 could not still proceed to their destination because their weight is lesser than 250 gross tonnage. There are also 132 rolling cargoes that could not proceed to their trip tonight. The Coast Guard is also expecting better weather conditions tomorrow and will issue another notice to mariners if they are lifting this suspension. But for the jurisdiction of the Coast Guard in northern Cebu, it remains under full suspension as it is also experiencing adverse weather conditions. And that's the latest here from Cebu. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks for the update, Annie.